Hey guys, it's Ben, and today I wanted to give you a more complete understanding of MIDI preferences and MIDI mapping. In the upper right-hand corner here, we've got MIDI track-in information. This is when you're sending note data to Ableton. And these are MIDI input and output indicators as well, but these will signify when Ableton is receiving remote control information. Let's go to our live preferences here. And in our MIDI preferences tab, you can see that I had a push to once connected. I will connect that later, but first we'll talk about how to set up a piano keyboard. We need to send note data to Ableton. Now, if you're completely new to MIDI mapping, notes are one form of MIDI data, and knobs are another form of MIDI data. Knobs will send data to Ableton in what's called CC or control change messages. First, I'll turn on my piano keyboard. Now, it remembers that I had my track input already on. This is a track input, and what that allows us to do is send in note information. So I'm going to hit some keys, and we can see that this is flashing here in the upper right-hand corner, and that means we are getting note data in. And I could change the input here from all ins to specifically my piano keyboard. And we see that it's flashing there. Now we would need to arm the track. And we can see it flashing there. Let's actually put a piano instrument in. Now when I hit keys, you hear the piano. So that's in its simplest term. But if we wanted to map a software knob to a hardware knob, we would actually need to go and enable remote. And so remote allows you to remotely control Ableton. So we want to have the remote input on. Now we can press the MIDI button up here, and now we can MIDI map any button or knob. Now let's exit MIDI mapping mode, and I can control the reverb amount with a knob. If you had an Ableton push, or you had another MIDI device that was in the control surface area, you wouldn't really need to worry about custom MIDI mapping because most things would already be mapped. I'll go ahead and turn on my push too. Now you should see some new MIDI ports pop up. But let's say you wanted to use the push 2 in user mode. I'm going to enable track input on the push 2. I explain more in depth the push 2 in user mode in my Mastering the Push 2 course, but I want to specifically talk about MIDI mapping in this video. With the push 2 in user mode and the MIDI from tab here, we actually see that the push is sending MIDI data when I press a pad. But if we wanted to see the pads light up, we would actually need to enable track output on the push 2 user port as well. Now we're not done yet. I actually have to pass the MIDI through. So here we are. And the last step is to either arm the track or send it to in on the monitoring. We'll just arm it. And now I see pads that will light up. So if we wanted to MIDI map a button or a knob from the push in user mode to a software knob, there's a couple different things we would need to do. If I go to live and preferences, and then I need to enable remote on the input. So let's say I wanted to mute this track on and off with a pad in user mode. There we go. Okay, I just pressed a pad. Cool. But I don't see that pad lighting up. I see pads lighting up from pressing track input, but I don't see this pad lighting up when I have MIDI mapped it. So to get that LED feedback information, I would need to go to the push to user port and enable output. Now my push to will light up red after I've MIDI mapped a value. Let's explain this again. Track is for note data. Sync is for sending MIDI clock information. You would very rarely use this unless you were trying to set up a drum machine with Ableton. And remote is for remotely controlling Ableton so that you can remotely control a software button or knob with a hardware button or knob. This last step is going to be a little bit more confusing, but let's go back to the piano keyboard. And I guess I don't need any MIDI output right now. I just want to set this up. So I said that track input is for note data only. That's not always the truth. Let's take a third-party plugin. And this is the Arturia Mini Moog. And I can hit notes with my piano keyboard. Now, like I said, if you want to remotely control a hardware button or knob in Ableton, you need to have remote enabled. And that is true if you want to remotely control something in Ableton. I could hit configure here. And let's say I wanted to map the cutoff frequency. Okay, here we are. And now I should be able to MIDI map this knob. And now it is moving. And we see that this tab up here, I had remote input information. Now, we can do that, but there are certain third-party plugins that already have some custom MIDI mapping. So let's go ahead and delete that. What's really interesting is if we go to this MIDI map mode and click on a value, certain third-party plugins will come pre-mapped, and in this case, I won't have to use remote. I can only use track. So let's exit out of this MIDI mapping mode. And if I close the plugin and let's disable remote for my keyboard and only have track input. Yes, I am. And I'm going to turn a knob. The knob will automatically move even though remote isn't enabled. And this is only on certain third-party plugins that come pre-mapped. The connection for remote control has already been made. Thanks for watching my video. If you have any other questions, feel free to ask it in the user discussions area.